So looking forward to speaking with you.
So finally, we managed to bring in 2,000 people. London is good.
Great, I haven't been
able to come to London and meet with people. And, you know, once you meet somebody, whole ball game is different with us. Even with you, when I meet you, the whole relationship takes a different turn when you meet somebody in person. So 2,000 people globally, I've decided. So 12th of June, we did the launch. Now we are trying to get into operations mode. Our production studios are ready and organized. So now I'm planning to do committee by committee launch and then do city by city launch. So within London, when we get everybody together, it creates a different sense of confidence when you see everybody on the same platform. I just wanted to hear from you in terms of DLC. What are you looking forward to in DLC and the committee you're representing, which is leadership and transformation?
You're a leader in X organization, and what you try and want to do is genuinely be an impactful leader, an effective leader to improve the social impact that your organization has. I suspect what you will hear from me is what you have heard from other organizations in the West, which is very much about inclusivity.
Yeah.
And what does inclusivity look like? Well, it's the same, in my opinion, whether this was Bombay or whether this was London or whether this was New York. I personally would use the same example for all three, but I suspect people think of it more in the West than they do in India. And when I mean inclusive, I'm talking about giving people equal opportunity despite their differences.
Right.
Now, the difference could be man and woman, which is basic, simple. In America and in England, but particularly in America, people have been looking at black persons, people and white people. And you've got all the other discriminatory ideas of how we jump to conclusions. Certainly in India, you've got caste. So I think the first thing a leader needs to do is to actually explore and understand the company that they are a leader in. Look at the culture of that organization. And when I mean culture, I mean employee engagement. I mean values. I mean influences between each other. You know, what kind of culture is it? Is it delegation kind of culture where I'm the boss and I tell you what to do? Or I'm the boss and I encourage you to own and do your own thing? Here again, the culture of countries will come in, because we have to understand that we're all different and we have to acknowledge and respect our differences, even something as nuanced as this.
DLC should be that platform that acts as a catalyst to every now and then keep pinning people and driving people. We're not correcting them. That's up to their own conscience and judgment. But we are here to tell them that these are the things which are qualities of a good leader. These are the things that are qualities of a good organization. And no matter how many zeros you make, I think that's financial balance sheet. But when it comes to a significant balance sheet, these are the things that matter to us. What I've done, Smita, is 26 committees. I've kept two reasons. One is either the committee delivers knowledge via the intellect of the committee members. Second, how can we utilize the collective power of the knowledge of and domain expertise of the committee to cause a social impact and different social impact in different countries? Because what's required in New York is not what's required in Calcutta. So my question to you is, what kind of social impact motivates you where you think you can contribute via the medium of your intellect?
Simply put, inclusion. That's what I do. That's what I live and breathe. What we do, because, you know, I run two organizations and both of them look at the culture of organizations. That's what we do. Under the headline of unconscious bias and under the headline of the other company, we look at culture through AI and the idea of using artificial intelligence to look at the culture of an organization that is global. It is based in the US, has many US branches, but also global.
Right.
Therefore, culture is different to different people. So you and me as human beings will not be able to do that without the help of something extraneous like AI. Once we get all the answers from the AI, then the human being will come in and suggest what kind of interventions, what kind of tools can go in that will genuinely make a different impact on the people of that organization. And you're talking 200,000-300,000 people working for the larger organization. It's global, it's big. And so that really excites me, because if out of those, let's call it 300,000 people, if out of those 300,000 people, 50 people, not even 1,000, genuinely understand what we're talking about and makes a difference, it's a job well done. Because those 50 people, if they are meaningful and they've understood it and they're leaders, will go out and then influence another 50 people.
We should make you do content piece on culture through AI. And I think it'll be a good take. Till date, I never thought that AI could be used for culture. That's a learning. I think you should expose people about it, and then they can subscribe to you, your institution, and engage with you commercially. Besides, so you can build that appetite to consume that content. That's something that we should do. Also, apart from working towards inclusivity, what else do you think we can utilize the power of our leadership committee to translate to the poorest of poor? How do we engage people across various societies to help them utilizing the knowledge and the power that's there with us?
I think you have to identify in amongst your leaders all over the world the people who have enormous influence in the countries that they live in. It has to be about power and influence and maybe even fame. So you have to get those kind of people where people of influence can talk about the change that can be made. And the poorest of the poor person is not looking at that Instagram post or that Twitter or whatever it might be. But other people are looking and reading, and then by sharing. So if we personally know somebody who can support us, because we may not be that level of influence or be that famous or world famous is what I'm thinking. I'm talking about people at that level. So right. If we want to change the world, first and foremost, we have to do it incrementally. Secondly, we have to get the support of people who might have a tiny bit more influence than we do.
Sure.
So that's where I see it. So I think it's then about looking. So if I were to summarize what I just said, it's asking us, all of us who are working within the Della Leadership Group, about our networks and who amongst our network has global influence.
Also, what we are doing, which was not planned by me last time when I had spoken to you, and now we've developed it, at least 50% of all the content we are generating is going to be put out on YouTube for free. That's also another way we're going to be actually causing impact. Because people who can't afford are going to be then consuming this content. You know, entrepreneurs who are just a shopkeeper, a small owner, very small businesses, but they can still take benefit of the knowledge that we are doing on this platform completely for free. That's one more way where we are showing our intentions that we are genuinely wanting to impact societies. And we are happy with the subscription money we get. We don't have any desire to earn any more money on this platform because our subscription money is going to keep us good enough. In fact, I hope to be a unicorn someday, whether a unicorn or a PepsiCon, but the social impact excites me much, much more than anything on the other side of the financial spectrum.
Just hearing your passion, because you asked me that question, or I mean, you don't ask me the question, but you were saying that if we can get leaders to be excited and to be passionate about whatever they're doing, then they'll do it every waking way. Well, guess what? I can see that in you. It keeps you awake at night, or it hopefully doesn't keep you awake, but it excites you at night. It motivates you in the morning. And that's what this is about, isn't it? It's about really wanting to make a difference and do the right things for the right reasons. And that gives you a sense of fulfillment.
Thank you. I consider myself really lucky that I don't think very few people in the world God have given an opportunity where they're in a position to actually cause social impact. I'm sitting in India, I'm being able to cause a social impact in New York or in Bangkok or in Singapore. So we're going to be doing everything through our cybersecurity committee to see how we can cause a positive change across, hopefully in July or early first week, August, to do a global a London chapter launch online, even if though physically we can't do. But after that, September or October, once things are open completely, let's look at what's happening to the Delta variant. But by September, October, we should do a physical launch in London. And we've got some amazing people and speakers who are incredible people. People like Thomas are absolutely incredible. They have their hearts in the right places. So we get all of them together, and that will create some magic across.
Wonderful. Look forward to it.
Pleasure. Always a pleasure to speak with you, and looking forward till we meet again.
Take care. Cheers. Good to meet you.
Bye. Bye-bye. See ya.